Hi, I'm going to explain and show you how easy it is to make a cute needle-felted robin bauble wearing a needle-felted Santa hat. This is a simple but effective beginner's needle-felting project. At the end I'll show you a second robin that I made slightly differently to show you how you can make your own robin unique. Step 1. Felting a ball. I'm going to whiz through this bit as you may already know how to needle-felt a ball, but in case you don't, I have another video where I explain in detail how to make a ball out of core wool. I'll put a link in the description below. The ball I've created here is exactly the same size as in that video. It's 3.7 centimeters or 1.5 inches in diameter. So let's get on with creating the robin. Step 2, applying the white wool. The next stage is to cover half the ball with white carded or merino wool. You don't need to do this if you're happy with the colour and texture of the core wool you've just used, but I find core wool is a bit rough. So here I've used a multi-needle tool containing 3 fine needles to needle felt the white wool over half of the ball. This will be the bottom of the bauble. Stab it lightly all over for a good 5 minutes to get a nice smooth surface. Step 3, applying the reddish brown wool. Let's imagine this ball is a tangerine. What we're going to do now is cover a couple of the segments with some reddish brown carded or merino wool. Here's what we're aiming for. I'm felting along in a slightly curved line along where the white stops and then up to the top of the robin's head. Make sure that where the reddish brown goes along the join, that you have a nice neat line. Take your time over this line because this will be visible and right at the front of the ornament. Now I've swapped my single fine needle and I'm neatening up the line, angling my needle in the direction I want the wool to go. Step 4, applying the dark brown wool. Next I'm going to cover about a third of the ball, so again here's an image of what we're aiming for. We're going to work round from the side of the robin over the top of his head. So start where the reddish brown joins the white on one side and felt the brown wool over the top in a line, making sure that the reddish brown makes up about a quarter of the ball. Continue to felt the brown all the way around, making sure that you meet up where you started around the back of the robin. It looks like the robin's got a very strange hairdo at the moment, so we're going to felt the rest of the dark brown down, making sure it has an even coat. So to use the tangerine analogy again, we have about 2 segments coated in reddish brown, then a third to almost half of the segment is in dark brown, and the remainder is in white. Step 5, the wings. Whenever I need to make 2 items the same size, I always get the wool ready for both before I start. It means that you know that you've got the same amount of wool for each, and you're more likely to have 2 the same size in the end. To help me get both wings the same, I've drawn and cut out a paper template of the wing shape, so that I can needle felt around it to get the initial shape. Or you can do it by eye if you prefer. Once you have the outline, you can needle felt the middle and fold in the excess wool, making sure that you keep the original shape. If you find you're going to have too much wool, then trim some away. I've left the tips of the wings a little bit less felted to give them a feathery look. Peel the wing off from your mat and needle felt on the other side. To make the edges neater, hold the wing between 2 rulers and stab along the edge. This way you're less likely to stab your fingers. Make the other wing in exactly the same way and attach them just overlapping the brown area slightly and angled down into the white area. Notice I'm only attaching the wing at the wide end and leaving the narrow end to fall away from the body. Step 6. Needle felting a Santa hat. So first we need a pattern. To create this, make 2 marks on a piece of paper 9 centimeters apart and make a mark in the middle of those at 4.5 centimeters. Then I've used one of my plates to draw a curve between the 2 marks. Using your mid 4.5 centimeter mark as a guide, in the centre measure 5.5 centimeters up from the curve and make another pencil mark. We'll call this mark A. Draw a line from each end of the curve to this mark A, then you're ready to cut your pattern out. I hope to have a link to the pattern and instructions for this in the description soon, so look out for that. Lay some red wool out on your mat, not too thick. You only want a thin felted material so that it bends easily. I had to make a second one of these as the first one was too thick. Then felt around the edge of your paper template so that you have shape. Then you can take away your template and felt in the middle all over, folding in the edges to the middle. This will cover any bare areas that you can see. By the way, if you're wondering about the fox in the corner watching us, I have a tutorial video showing you how I made this Christmas tree decoration on my channel. I'll put a link to it at the end of this video. After I'd carefully peeled it up from the mat, I noticed a small area near the top that you could see through, so I added a tiny bit more red wool. Needle felt it on the other side and neaten up the edges by sandwiching it between 2 rulers, as we did with the wings. Now curl the felt round so that the 2 ends of the curve meet and the 2 straight edges overlap by about 3 millimeters or 1/8 of an inch. Starting at the tip of the hat, needle felt down this join as if you were sewing the 2 sides together. Be careful not to put your fingers inside the hat while doing this. Just hold the join away from the other side of the hat, being careful not to stab yourself. This is a bit fiddly, so take your time. Once you're happy with the position of the hat on the robin's head, lightly needle felt round the base of the hat to hold it in position. Have the hat folded over and needle felt under the fold out of sight so that it stays in its folded position. Then take a long thin strip of white wool and felt it all round the base of the hat. To make the bobble on the end of the hat, take a small piece of white wool, roll it up and felt it into a small ball and attach it to the tip of the hat, making sure it's securely attached. This can be a bit fiddly, but keep stabbing through the bobble into the red hat. Step 7, the tail. Take some more dark wool and fold it in half and pinch the loose ends together. Then needle felt down the fold so that it's about 1.5 centimetres or 5/8 of an inch wide. Then pinching in the wool to create the narrow part of the robin's tail, felt this all over whilst holding it in shape. Be sure to leave the ends beyond where you've been pinching unfelted, as you're now going to spread these unfelted ends out and attach them to the opposite side of the red face area between the two wings. This should join onto the brown wool that we covered the ball with earlier. Here you can see I'm using a single fine needle to felt the tail at its narrowest part. This helps to make the tail stick out slightly. Step 8 is the face. First we're going to make the beak. Take a thin slither of dark brown wool and roll it up as tightly as you can in this very small sausage shape. Start stabbing it all round with a fine needle. Again, watch your fingers, I managed to stab myself here. Ouch. You need to create a cone shape that's narrower at the tip, leaving some short strands at the other end to attach it with. Once you've stabbed it until quite firm, check it's the right size for your robin and place it right between the wings in the centre of the red area and just above the centre vertically. Then attach it by stabbing the loose ends straight into the head. Work your way all round the beak, making sure it's securely attached. As always, for the eyes, I've got two tiny pieces of black wool and I'm rolling them between my fingers to check that they're about the same amount of wool. This will help you get the eyes the same size. Take one of the pieces of black wool and needle felt it into a very small circle, 3 millimetres or 1/8 of an inch in diameter. The eyes should be positioned just above the nose and approximately 7 millimetres or 1/4 of an inch away from the nose. I like to take a tiny bit of white felt and felt it into the top right hand part of the black, just to give them that bit of life. To figure out how the robin will hang from the tree, put the needle through his hat. I've used a fairly thick sewing needle and a piece of thick red thread that's 23 centimetres or 9 inches long. As I said earlier, I made two of these robins. The second one has his hat further forward so it doesn't look like he's got a fringe. This was after receiving some feedback that the first one looked a bit like one of the Beatles. I'd love to hear what you think in the comments. If you'd like to see how I made the fox ornament that was watching us, you can watch that here. And don't forget to subscribe to see more like this. Thanks for watching.